In this tutorial, I'm going to show how to use pivot tables. Now, the question is, what is a pivot table? A pivot table is a very, very powerful reporting tool that allows you to summarize data really, really effectively in a really simple way. Now, what I've got here is a simple spreadsheet with three different people, Phil, Katie, and Paula, and what they've spent their money on in what week. In week three, for instance, Phil has spent £18 on alcohol, and in week four, Katie spent £17 on food. Now, there's a lot of data here, and I want to summarize it quickly and effectively. And to do that, I use a pivot table. So the first thing I do is highlight the data I want to include in my pivot table. Then I go to Data, Pivot Table, and Pivot Chart Report. Now, it'll ask me what you want to do. I'm going to use a Microsoft Excel list because that's what I've created here. And I'm going to generate a pivot table. I'm not going to do the second one, just the top one. So I go to Next, and now it says, what data do you want to use? Now you can change the data, but because I originally highlighted the data, that's where it's automatically slotted in here. You can change that if you want to. I'm not going to. Go to Next, and I want this pivot table to appear in a new worksheet. I could have an existing one, but I don't want to. I want it in a brand new sheet. So I go to Finish, and this is what you'll see. Now here, over here, you've got a property pivot table field list, and what I want to do is drag certain things into certain areas. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click the Who field here, and I'm going to drag that into the Row area. Drop Row fields here, and I'm going to drop that in. And you can see that's added Katie, Paula, and Phil's data. Then I go to Week, click on that, and drag that over to the row. You can see it's in the row because it's a vertical I-beam there, and I drop that there. And then finally, I take What, and I drag that over. So I've got Who, Week, and What in the row area here. And then finally, I take the amount from here, and I add this to the data items area here, and drop that. And that's my pivot table pretty much done. It now shows data for Katie in weeks 3, 4, and 5, and it's shown in week 3 she's drunk and spent £16 on alcohol. In week 4, alcohol and food, it's shown the amount, and it subtotals everyone, and then gives you a full total at the end. It's done the same for Paula and the same for Phil, which is really cool. But you can also filter. You say I didn't want Phil's data, I could filter that and get rid of it. Or I can get it back by going like that. I could filter certain weeks out, and you'll see when I filter a week out, you can see at the moment Katie's total is £80. If I filter week 3 out, click on OK, you can see the total has gone down to £64, and for all the others as well. But I can bring it back and click on OK. Now the really, really cool bit is that you can rearrange what you want things to sort by. Now if I don't want to see the data arranged by who has drunk what in what week, I want to see the weeks summarized. I click on the week data here and drag that over to the left. And you can see now it's summarized by week 3. So week 3 now, Katie's spent £16 on alcohol, Paul has spent £55 on all of these, and Phil has spent £69 on all of these. So it's summarized now by week rather than by who. But similarly, you can move the what over to the left, and it'll summarize by what's been drunk or eaten or driven. So you can see now in week 3, Katie, Paula and Phil have spent this much on alcohol. So it's looking now by the food or alcohol or transport. So you can rearrange it any way you want, and it's a really, really handy way of summarizing data without too much effort. And hopefully, if you have a little play with it, it'll be of use to you.